Hey guys, what's going on? It's Nock. Welcome along to the stream. Hope you are very well. It is Tuesday the 25th of September. And we are back with Infinifactory, of course. So, kind of want to start off today by something I announced earlier on via my Twitter and my blog. Not that I post on my blog that often anyway. But yeah, I am returning exclusively to Twitch again. Long story short, I went over to Mixer because I was really intrigued and interested by the kind of Mixer offering, the interactivity and the really low latency and stuff. But as much as I've tried and kind of tried to make it work, I was still building a following over here on Twitch, and I wasn't really creating much of a community and getting many views and follows and different bits and pieces over on Mixer. So yeah, I kind of decided, I tried it, it didn't work, and I was coming back to Twitch. So I'm back exclusively to Twitch, no more of the restream stuff, etc, etc. So without further ado, let us start with laser calibration target tonight. Alright, so looks like I've got a painting thing to do.
While I was with the overlords, me and my sort created many of the tools you've been using. We usually work in pairs. Sometimes it helped, having an extra forearms. The conveyor was the first tool we engineered. Real simple, just a belt, a motor, and a highly unstable power core. And the eviscerator? That was all me.
I'm not sure I know, remember what the eviscerator was, to be honest. So, this one, this one kind of reminds me of the first time we actually saw a painter. That puzzle. And I'm kind of thinking, straight off the bat here, what I'm going to do is, do I have to paint one side? I hope so. Okay, so what I'm thinking is bring it along, get the whole thing painted, bring it across here, and then kind of like when we get to here, so kind of like here, if I can have something which basically just like pushes it for one block forwards, but then it comes straight back again when like the middle hits there, that's kind of what I'm thinking straight off the bat right there. So yeah, I mean, so let's think how we're going to do this. I mean, we have probably best to do it in like rows and strips, which is okay, but I then don't know how I would do, so I could like rotate it all the way around. Let's go on, Flame Tusk. Welcome to the stream, buddy. We can't actually see the on-screen chat there. Let me move that slightly. Ah, adverts, man. Adverts suck. There we go. We want that to come from the top, I guess, but hey, there's a nice little space on Infinifactory. Look, just for the chat right here. So let's stick that there. How you doing, buddy? And also, while you're here, thank you very much for the follow on Twitch. I know she followed, sorry, on Twitter. Thank you very much, appreciate that. So yeah, I'm thinking, gonna want to, need to move it across a little bit first. Oh, you created it today. Cool. Many excavators? Why would an excavator help? Why on earth would... Eviscerators. Okay. What was the eviscerator again? These. Okay, well, what I'd kind of thought about in my early analysis of this level was... kind of running these things past here at different intervals. My problem is, what I've kind of like thought about doing, there's only four sides to the painting cube thing, and I would need five. So, kind of like, straight off the bat, that kind of screws me over a little bit. So, yeah. So, I can only assume then, the solution you are referring to would be to do something in the lines of... could have them here. I was thinking, could I not use lasers? Surely lasers would be more block friendly than using the other, whatchamacallit, thingamajigs. Like that. So, once we have that... just gonna want to do that, take it all the way across. Okay. So, was it six wide? Five. 5, and then when we get to here, we can rotate. Oh, is that 7? It is 7. Yeah, I think I know how I could use a single laser. I could do something like this. And then... how many does it need to pulse? 1, 2, 3, 4. So as long as I put my... do that. But then, by doing that there, hold on. By putting that there, I'm going to use as much sort of like blocks on the conduit than I am anything else, no? Also, just give me a second. I'm just going to change the chat settings just real quickly on Streamlabs. That looks a little bit... obstructive. Oh man. Okay. Or you could move the sensor so that the to be lasered blocks activate the laser. Well, that works, actually. Because that gives me 3. That could actually work. Okay. That could work. Teamwork, flame test, teamwork. Alright, so it's gonna then drop over here. So, I think I'm going to need to use the welders though all the way, aren't I? Yeah, it wasn't the best idea, was it? Put welders here instead. Would it be better to not rotate them? I don't really think I need to rotate them, do I? Let's think. Drop off the edge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Weld them here. Yeah, so that's what I was that was my original kind of analysis of the level is, as I go past the red one, I'll kind of like push it forward, but then have a, I guess as it's pushed forward, and then I need to retract it by kind of releasing that as well. So, you've never done it in rows, only cons. Yeah, I was kind of thinking, can I think of a way to, as it comes here, so like have a pusher which pushes it for one and then retracts it straight away. So I didn't need like conveyors set up. Conveyors would be set up. I suppose I would push it on the last, and then the first one would then hit another trigger, which would push it back. I have an idea. So, once that hits there, I need to think of a release mechanism here, don't I? So, should be able to do that, and then perfect. Excellent. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is that the right way to rotate it? I've got to rotate the whole thing, haven't I? I did listen to the terminal. Yes, I did. Should I go and listen to it again?
While I was with the overlords, me and my sort created many of the tools you've been using. We usually work in pairs. Sometimes it helped, having an extra forearms. The conveyor was the first tool we engineered. Real simple, just a belt, a motor, and a highly unstable power core. And the eviscerator? That was all me.
Alright, so, yes, okay. So, pause. So from there, you could even have the rotator there. Would that work? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Should work. Okay.
then. Three, four, five, six. Need to move it along once more. I think we're good. Okay, so this is where the this is where the magic needs to happen. I come here. This is the top. So it needs to raise up to for a start. So we're going to have to use a lifter. This so wrong. Let's go higher still. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. Check. Excellent. One, two, three. I think I want to do this one before. Run it and pause it after it gets welded. All right, here. The area select? What do you mean? I don't know what you mean! I need to move this across one. Oh. I need to shift it all across one. Good eyes, buddy. Well spotted. All right, well, at least it's an easiest fix. Okay, so then the counter needs to go here. that, get rid of that. That one goes there. So now I'll do that. Then I'm gonna do that. A rotator there. Conveyor here. Rotator here. So then, actually works out pretty well because I needed to adjust this anyway by a block. There. Oh, my days. That is a lot easier, isn't it? All right, so let's see if we've done this correctly. We have not, but all we need to do is that. Okay, so that is now in the perfect position. So how am I going to do this? I could have a counter here. That's going to want to be better on this side. And then next to the counter, will that automatically work? Does. Do you know what? Actually, piston platform sensor. I was thinking about maybe taking it up, going higher. Delay the signal a cycle? What, by pushing it to the red, you mean? But if I delay it, it won't get pushed over in the first instance, right? Unless what you suggest is move it to here. Because that would work, right? Oh, I didn't check it. Did that do it in the right place? It's gone into cooler. Welcome on stream, buddy. Hope you're well. How you doing tonight? What's going on, Dr. What's going on, Dr. Kekalan? MD, welcome on to stream, buddy. Hope you're well. How has your week been? I don't know how I would delay the cycle though, Flame Tusk, is what I'm... Place the pusher one block to the left. So... You're saying this, right? Alright, so I think, if I understand you right, Flame Tusk, what you are suggesting is we would have not that. Don't want that. Something like this, right? And then let's go back another one. I can't adjust the counter though into cooler, because if I adjust the counter and make it an 8, it's going to throw things out. Or is it? Hold on a second. Eight, but then it would need two on the next one. If I set it to 8, though, it will push up on the first one. But then that means the next one that comes through will need 2, then it'll need 3, then it'll need 4, then it'll need 5, and I don't think it would work. Yeah. Because it'll just keep incrementing more and more that you'll need to push off. We had the timer here. The problem is, I gotta push it, and then I gotta pull it back again. So, I'm alright pushing it, but when I pull it back, it then hits the counter and gives it a false reading for the next time. So, alright, so I'm gonna try, I think what Flame Tusk is suggesting is set up like this. To which I would have a pusher here, and the pusher has a sensor. So, this one oh, but no, wait, that can't. Oh no, wait, yeah. And then the pusher is on there, so when it comes over to here, it pushes this over to here. This one then goes back, and then it can go off that way. I think. All right, let's see. Put a platform on the pusher, which activates the sensor. Will that? Does that work? Oh my god, it does. Okay. Alright, in which case, let's do this. And that pushes that. In the original design, the counter doesn't activate again because the pusher and the sensor were next to each other.
Yeah, it will always give a false reading.
Oh, hold on. I need. Oh, that's gonna. No. Because that's then gonna. Oh. Orthodoxed. Boom. But it's pushing too. Still, this issue I had before. It's pushing too early. But now I can go and I need to then shift this across. If that's what you were saying, Intercooler, I do apologize. But yeah, the problem is that's now giving me a false reading. Next time this comes across, it's going to push early. And then it's going to push earlier. And then it's going to push earlier. And that's what we was trying to avoid. Yeah, but we can't set the counter to 8 because you're just going to offset the problem. Let me show you. You're just offsetting the problem, and it's just going to, it's not going to happen straight away, but then it'll work the first time. See, the first one goes through and it's going to push early, and then it'll push late. So yeah, send it to 8 isn't going to work, unfortunately. So, it's about 7. Yes, okay. I see what you're saying now, Flame Tusk, I think. I thought that would have to be there, but no, because that's going to push out and push forward, so I missed it. Oh, because, I know why. That needs to connect to that. So if I do that, right? Okay. Checking. That's it. Okay, excellent, excellent, excellent. Stop, stop, stop. And then we need to rotate. And then actually, I'm going to go this way, I think. May seem like a bit of an arse about face way of doing this, but I do believe I've got to go this way. Drop off there and then go forwards. Let's try it. Let's try it. Can't rotate there. Alright, so in which case let's bring a little bit further across. And then we need to rotate this way, rotates that way. Another one? Should find out. No, it's going to fail because I haven't got a thingy there. I tried solving it. Why would I do such a thing? Oh, shit. I am rotating the wrong way. Duh! Oh, that's probably going to screw everything up again. Yay for being observant, me. Finally. I'm pretty sure I could like mass it. I could put set the input rate to max as well here. Oh. Maybe not. Maybe not. Let's just run through it. Any more do you want? Man, that's a slow ass process.
Obviously, in your solution, Flame Tusk, you was, I mean, considering what you said you were doing, like, with all the, like, excavator things, we actually got the same block score, which is interesting. Considering I only kindly use one laser, but, didn't you say you, like, you use columns instead? Surely columns would be, make it more... If you're doing like vertical columns of five, wouldn't that make it even more difficult to... I guess not, because you could just run one column straight past the painter, the red painter. I suppose you like run it past the white one, drop it down so all the white gets painted, take it around, lift it up a little bit, split off one, paint that one, weld them all together, and do the exit. Kind of something like that anyway. I guess is what you would, your solution would be. All right, well, next we are going to have a look at life support system. Seems like you're all on your own on these ones. Let a column go on each side of the painter. Okay. All right. So, and there is stuff in the middle. Great. It's kind of what I didn't want. All right, let's see what Ortis has to say here.
That Maruvo kid is fascinated by you soft skin meatbags, no offense, but doesn't care about me, last of my sort, lone wanderer Ortis. Nobly traveling the stars, building things for you. I don't like it.
So, straight off the bat, we need to use some excavator things. So I need to bore out that on all sides. Could be quite tricky to deal with. Actually, no, because we could just... If we drop it, we could bring in some excavators on each side using a sensor. So just spitball in here. So we could do this. So that's gonna go there. So you want one, two. Need to come up a little bit further out. Have that, then we need them here, which would be, actually sit back here, and at which point we'd have a sensor here. Oh, it's joined to that conveyor, isn't it?
All right, well. Fango's our theory. And that solution. So, Flame Tusk suggesting here we rotate into the... that's kind of what I was just suggested there, Intercooler. As it was falling, I was going to use the sensor to kind of like push the blocks in. But yeah. Oh, I think I see what you mean. So, you would offset the rotator to there, and I could have my... Okay. So, if that's pivoting on there... Would that be the right place? And then I think you said you would do... rotate it out again, right? Okay. So then I could have... have one on this side though as well, can I? So I could then put another one there, and then I can put these ones here. I can have one here. Think it would go here, right? Yes, these are useful tips. I think I just gotta rotate it out again, or else I'm not gonna be able to. See, my big concern is once I've rotated it. And we've cut all this out. My concern is, as I use this rather handy area tool, how do I get it to not... kind of well, I guess I could rotate it out again, right? So that puts me there, and then I would have conveyor on here, which then pushed it off. Alright, so. The base is done. The base is done. Alright, let's take a look at what's going on over here. We've got... So straight away, I need to trim off the top two, right? I would need to repeat this. Yeah, okay, so if I have two of these. Yeah, it would help. That's not a bad shout. Let's just do that and that. Yeah, you know, that really helps, as a matter of fact. All right, so. So that'll be okay. So, could I possibly stall that? Yeah, I'm going to stall them with the blocks. I'm just kind of trying to plan in my head how I'm going to act, whether it's feasible and whether it works. So, it's all about the timing. Thank you. Yep. Yep, could do that. I'm just thinking of whether I can... Just playing. Don't criticize just yet. Place them opposite with each other and use two pushes to push them on to each other at the same time. All right, so let's make this ground level then, just for devil's sake. Trying to think here. Which one is going to have yeah, an AND gate would be really helpful right now. That works. That works quite nicely. I thought it did. I just need to do that instead then.
Hmm. There we go, boys. That's how we're rolling. Okay. We may be in the original position without blockers, but the crucial thing here is... The crucial thing here is we are equalizing the timing. That's the important thing, I feel. So, we're equalizing the timing. And OBS has gone down. Fantastic. All right, YouTube, I will sort this issue and I will be right back. Alright guys, apologies for that. My power line adapters decided to die a horrible death. But yes, we are back. Let's head back to this now. Thanks for sticking with it. So, I don't know if you caught what I was trying to say before that stream crashed. what we have achieved now is we have achieved normalization. So to demonstrate, we now have a 1-to-1 ratio of these blocks, which is the key factor here. So what I actually want to do is, it's kind of like a race against time almost, that I need to get. Alright, so I need to bring these ones closer, basically. Is the moral of the story. Okay, it's just better. Area select tool, don't fail me now. I think it's magic. I love that. I got one too many. Think welding it on the platform is easier. Okay, interesting. Out of sync anyway. So scrub this away. So are we gonna get the 3x3 here like this? Well, if I make it do that. Okay. So, what we're going to do here is my typical sort of let's do it here actually. So this is going to be my like typical kind of, let's arrange all these pieces. I meant not having the tubes drop at all before welding the tops to them. Okay.
Let's leave that set up like that. So here, we're at the same spot here, right? Travels one. Travels one. Let's come out a bit more. One, two. One, two. Weld. Excellent. So now we can do the 1, 2, 3 to there. Sensor on here. Call Flame Tusk. Good call, buddy. Okay, and then is that already in place? Okay, so let's have them coming. There. Yeah, this is going to give me problems. Unless I was to do the sides first and weld them on. There and there. If I had it pushed in. I need to get rid of all this a minute. So, wow, that was a bit of a fail. But then them conveyors are going to get in the way. Yeah, how do you mean about the original rotation? Do you mean like... I think I know what you mean, actually. So what you mean is line up all the oxygen tanks, but then have it rotating to weld it around. So rather than having like these set up here, these would be welders, I think is what you're referring to, correct? That could work if I could just figure out and think of how the design might go for that. Timing would have to be really spot on for that though, because as it rotates, it needs to be dropping. It's an interesting idea though. Very interesting idea. We'd effectively have like this, right? You see what I mean though about this, like how fast this would happen? You You could have some, like, blockers on this edge here with sensors to detect this kind of thing. Let me see if I can create it, what I'm talking about. So you'd have, if you can have a sensor there. And then your blocker would be here. Need to go back another one. I'm just spitballing, so don't worry. Could even have the rotator fall into place attached to blockers. That's completely in the wrong position there. Yeah, I don't know what I'm trying to achieve there. Because that's blocking it, and that's causing an issue. Okay, so. Let's take Flame Tusk's advice. I need to delay this if I can. Okay, just gets delayed there. All right, I need to just focus a minute. I need to I still think having my sensor set up here . First tank's gotta go here. Okay. That's tank number one. Okay, so then that pushes along. You think do one at the same time? Okay, in which case, if we can do that, that goes there, that one goes there. But that's the issue, isn't it? Could use a lifter. It's not just that conveyor that's in the way, though, is it? Okay. What if I build this up? So then I want to do that. Then stick with me, guys. That wants to go. Oh, shizness. Well, that will teach me. No, that's what's wrong with it. I Okay. Then welders.
But then I need to go even higher.
Jeez. I need to go another two higher with this. The lifter, or to lift it here. Okay. Then la 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 la. That. What dumbass. Okay. We're getting there. We're getting there. So this one went to there. This one went to... there. All right. These two can sit in a holding area. One, two. So then once I get to here, then gonna do here, here, what's going on, poor Ponky? I do actually. Who'd have thunk it? What's going on, buddy? Hope you're all well. Welcome to the stream. Oh. Yeah. Yeah, I should really sleep, to be fair. They say sleep is good. Yeah, I saw it, playing test. One more over. And we are home and dry. How's all things poor Ponky Games coming along? I'll admit, it's a very messy solution in the middle there. But I'm going to take it. You're making a flower arrangement game that you're being lazy with? Hey, man. You're making a game. You're doing something productive. That's not lazy in my eyes, buddy. Excellent. Oh man, yeah. Other than the cycle score, yeah, I trumped you, Flame Tusk. I trumped you. I think the thanks for like giving us like the rotation advice on like the 3x3 block. That really helped. But I think what really helped over here was like this. This mechanic here, which kind of like normalized the blocks like to a 1-to-1 ratio, and it kind of got them all in sync. And then after that, I mean, I know this is freaking, geez, this is like Piccadilly Circus right here, but yeah, it certainly helps. Then you can like position them in two different welding spots. I would have really liked to have done something like this with the welders, but yeah, I just think that the timing would have been too tight. The next level is an easy one. How long do you think it will take? I'll certainly go for a little bit longer. Okay, so laser. Let's try and get our basic shape. Okay. Quite conscious about doing anything over there as well. And then... Alright, well, I think it's a bit done. Nice! Yeah, I'd kind of gone. I was kind of working on a hammer project again, and. I don't know, I've fallen into the same pitfalls I always do. I don't complete it. Which is rather frustrating for me, I'll be honest. I really just want to get a hammer map out. At the start of like the map making process, I'm like really enthusiastic. And then... I don't know, it's kind of weird. I kind of just... Things happen and I lose motivation or I don't get time to do what I want to do. And then... Yeah, it's frustrating for me. Alright, so... These are the same height, right? Yeah, I mean, I was trying to hammerize like my latest workshop map as my project. I mean, I've got like so much. I've just got so many hours in hammer. I just cannot put the finishing touches to something or you know find the right kind of motivation to get done. Anyway, I need to concentrate here for a minute. So like a diagonal. If that goes higher, that needs to go higher as well. Doofus. Okay. Try to do up, down, up. What if I put some lifters in then? Oh, that's right, because that's affected like that, isn't it? Arrive on the down left block. Hold on. So to arrive on the down left block, I would need to do this, right? Yeah. Pull it down with one and move it to the left. Alright, so what you're saying is, if I'm reading you correctly, to go Yeah, that's a thing. That would need to be a conveyor. Hold on, let me... I want to take this like back to a bit more basic. Of course, when I say basic, to rotate, maybe? Okay, well, I can't do that. So, I think it's a non-starter. So, it's not. I was thinking, like, if I could, like, get the blocker, push it on with the top, it hits a point and then it travels backwards, but nope. I'm assuming however I paint with the white, the same kind of technique and solution is going to be applied to the red. Try this side. Needs to fall. One, two, three. How would I break the cycle? Top right needs to be painted first, or... So, if you're saying top corner painted first, right? That means... I gotta come in here. And then... Okay. So I have this. So I'm thinking I've got to...
So do top, move it across, move it down.
I'm so confused. So I'm too low. I was moving it to the left to try and see if I could give myself some more space to do something. Didn't work. Yeah, I am pretty tired. Alright, so And then do this.
I had something similar to that, like, right from the outset.
Comes over on this edge. But from the original plan, yeah, the original plan, I was just about to say that this top right hand corner needs doing first. But hold on, I've got this the wrong way around. If it needs to be, if it wants to be, if you're saying I need to, actually, thought it'd be there. But I think you said originally that I need to do like both the middle ones. So if the lifter is only the first paint, yeah, it's got to be on the... Does it work through conveyors? Which then means I'm going to need to do that. That means... Okay. Maybe I need another one. No, cause I need to do it for two, so go there. Maybe there. That's in the way. That needs to drop. Oh my freaking God. Yeah, I still need to... Missed one. Where is it missing it? Because that needs to be one further across. thing I need to move it out because it's getting painted, isn't it? Oh. I mean, it's got to be the same, right? So it's got to do that. It's got to do that. So okay, so it goes to there. Then that's going to go to so it's got to go they stay in the same places, right? Jeez. Okay. So now I just need to replicate this on these sides. So I want to come in with this corner first. Yeah, I know about the top bit. Don't worry. I'd rather just get the painting all sorted first. Okay, so move across two. Alternative light, pass. Okay, so then we're going to here. One there. Then one here. That. Excellent. The name doesn't ring a bell, Flame Tusk, anyway, so it's probably a good indication that I haven't played it. Oh, I hate it when I do that. Jeez. Okay. And then from there, we can just take that over to here, slide it in at the side. So, where is the best place? Doesn't ring a bell. So, maybe I can, like, deliver it in here somehow. How dare you fix a map? How dare you? Loving this area, select tool. Has to be said. Just where to frickin' do this, man. Thank you. Where to do it with enough of a delay? Let's go for the drunk man's placement. Still not even in the right place, man. It's actually holding that up. Alright, so let's think about where I need to like get this out of here first. So, I could have that as a holder. And that needs to drop onto there. That one needs to be a touch higher. Can we attack while you're dragging? Do 5. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe we are done.
Man, that was tough. I don't know, that painting thing, man. Oh shit.
Yeah, I mean, the painting thing, though, blew my freaking mind. I said, I don't know, maybe I'm just a bit... Maybe I'm just a bit tired. Maybe tiredness is creeping in. But... Yeah, that was some crazy stuff, man. Oh man, that area at all. Didn't like it then. Yeah, to be fair, I was kind of... Oh, I bet that's not going to work. It could work. If I slide it this way... And then... Slide it that way. I was kind of debating whether or not to actually stream tonight. I was kind of feeling a bit tired, sat on my couch. Just watched some telly earlier. But I was like, no. I said, you know, it would be stream night tonight, so... Oh, shit. Didn't think about that, did I? But like I've said before, though, this... I feel like... Right now, like at this stage of the game, Infinifactory is it's got a real draining game. It's really, really draining at times. Don't get me wrong, I am really still enjoying the game. Oh man, I need to rotate that one. And I've enjoyed it all. I do like puzzle games, as you all know, but it's like, tonight, I feel like at this stage of the game, I'm spending at least an hour per puzzle. So, that's kind of why I cut it down to... I cut it down to like one stream a week because it's getting too much for me, kind of like doing this two or three times a week. The intensity was like ridiculous. I'm not high enough. Why am I not high enough now? I don't understand. Wow. That's some insane puzzling there. I mean, on top of that as well, kind of like in the daytime, I used to stream at lunchtimes. Some of you may or may not know this. So my regular streaming shot used to be 1 p.m. BST GMT, whichever time zone Britain's on at the time. But I kind of stopped doing that because that's now my portal recording time, so I can spend more time in the evenings streaming longer or
just basically recording other videos, but I basically spend that time now doing my Portal 2 map recordings. And like some of the maps I'm playing at the minute are just like this game. They're taking hours and multiple days to record. So it's just like with that, and then like trying to play Infinifactory two or three times a week is just like extra and I just can't cope. It's crazy, I know. But hey, you know, I gotta, you know, round of applause to you guys in the chat, because I don't think I would have got my head around the painting without so many hints. So yeah, as much as I kind of like to solve things on my own sometimes, thank you very much, because I don't know where I would have gone. And, you know, probably being a bit tired didn't really help. So, all right, anyway, we got one more in this area, and then whatever's behind here, I'm really not looking forward to. But as always, guys, I appreciate you all tuning in. Infinifactory will be back a week Wednesday. A week tomorrow, we'll be back with some more Infinifactory. The next level might need a stream of its own. All right, well, we've done that before earlier on in the one of the Overlord missions, so I'm sure we can do it again. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Like I said, a week Wednesday will be the next Infinifactory stream, and exclusively here on Twitch. Thanks for the support. Enjoy the rest of your evening, morning, whatever time of day it is for you. But till next time, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.